Thank you. Laudator Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. A very warm welcome to you on behalf of Vatican Media, Vatican Radio, and all my colleagues here at the Vatican's Dicastery for Communication. My name is Joseph Tullock, and I'll be providing you with the English language commentary for this live broadcast of Pope Francis' general audience on today, Wednesday the 22nd of May 2024. The event is taking place in St. Peter's Square in the Vatican. It was very overcast until not very long ago. Now, the first bits of blue in the sky can be seen. So hopefully that bodes well for today's audience. And today Pope Francis will be continuing with his series of catecheses on the vices and the virtues. And his topic today will be the virtue of humility. The Pope is currently, as he normally does before the general audience, driving around the square in the Pope Mobile, greeting some of the pilgrims that have come today, blessing some babies, waving. And he's now headed up towards that podium that those of you watching television will be able to see, where he'll arrive shortly and then begin today's audience. A very warm welcome to all of you as Pope Francis takes another baby and gives her a quick blessing. A very warm welcome to you, I was saying, whether you're joining us via our Vatican News YouTube channel, Radio Maria Papua New Guinea, Radio Maria England, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Salt and Light TV, at Madison TV, EWN TV, Uganda Catholic Television, Catholic TV, Luminous Radio India, or via any local or diocesan radio station around the world. And a very special welcome to all of our friends from the DCYIA, that's the Deaf Catholic Youth Initiative for the Americas. For those of you who don't already know, you can visit our Vatican News YouTube channel to find translation of this general audience into American Sign Language. It will be up a few hours after the event finishes. The children who were in the Pope Mobile with the Pope as he toured around are now getting out as the Pope now heads towards the podium. And lastly, this broadcast is also available live right now on the Vatican Media audio app and the Vatican News website, which you can access at www.vaticannews.va. And it's also being streamed live on our Facebook page. Welcome to all of you who are following us via Facebook. Those of you who watch or listen every week know, for those who are maybe joining for the first time, the format for today's event is basically that we start off with a reading from Scripture. This week it will be from the Gospel of Luke. And that's read out in various languages. It's a very short passage. After that, Pope Francis will give a catechesis in Italian, of which I'll be providing you with a simultaneous English language translation. And that will be followed by a summary of the Pope's catechesis in various languages. I won't be translating the summaries, as you'll have just heard the entire thing in English, but I will translate the Pope's greetings to the faithful of each language group. The general audience will then conclude with the singing of the Our Father in Latin and the Holy Father's Apostolic Blessing, which goes out to all of you listening live, whether in person in the Vatican or at distance via this or other broadcasts. So the Pope Mobile is now parking directly in front of the entrance to St. Peter's Basilica, and reversing towards the podium, Pope Francis will be getting out shortly and will be getting started. I said that today Pope Francis is continuing with his cycle of catechesis on the vices and the virtues. That's been going on for a few months now. And last week he reflected, so I said that this week he'd be reflecting on humility. Last week he reflected on the virtue of charity, saying that this theological virtue, quote, comes from God and is directed towards God and enables us to love God and to love our neighbour as God loves them. The Pope began his reflection with a passage from St. Paul, which says, so faith, hope and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. The Holy Father noted that these words were addressed to the Christians of Corinth, who suffered from division and strife, even in the celebration of the Eucharist. And speaking of charity, Pope now taking a moment to greet the readers at today's general audience, as he normally does. These are normally people from the Vatican's Dicastery for Communication. He'll be translating what he says into various languages throughout today's audience. Going again back to last week's audience, the Pope continued and saying, quote, who knows, perhaps in the community of Corinth nobody thought they had committed a sin. If that was the case, they might have found Paul's condemnation of their strife incomprehensible. Some more babies being brought to greet the Pope. I think these must be the children of a Vatican employee. Normally it's Vatican employees that are seated in this part of the square for the general audience. Big crowd today, and I said it was overcast before. The sun is coming out, so it looks like the weather's going to be quite nice. So hopefully a very enjoyable experience for the people that have gathered to see the Pope. Some of you might be able to see the men in striped uniforms who are now marching towards the podium. These are, of course, the Swiss Guard, who've been serving the Pope and the Vatican for a couple of centuries now. These striped uniforms are their ceremonial outfits, but you can also see them, they're less conspicuous, wearing these dark suits around the Pope, and that's when they're kind of on duty and really doing the close protection work. There's about 100, slightly over 100 Swiss Guards in total. They all come from Switzerland after completing military service in Switzerland. And it's now being announced in Italian that the Holy Father will open the general audience with the sign of the cross and a liturgical greeting. Let us prepare ourselves to receive his words and receive his blessing.
Nel nome del Padre, del Figlio e dello Spirito Santo. La pace sia con voi.
Pope Francis says, "Peace be with you." The response was, "And with your spirit," and now we'll hear that reading from the Gospel of Luke in various languages, starting with Italian.
Allora Maria disse, "L'anima mia magnifica il Signore, e il mio spirito esulta in Dio, mio Salvatore, perché ha guardato l'umiltà della sua serva. D'ora in poi tutte le generazioni mi chiameranno beata." Parola del Signore.
And now we'll hear that same reading in French.
De l'Évangile selon Saint Luc. Marie dit alors, « Mon âme exalte le Seigneur, exulte mon esprit en Dieu mon Sauveur. Il s'est penché sur son humble servante. Désormais, tous les âges me diront bienheureuse. Parole du Seigneur. »
Now we hear that reading in English. It's taken from the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke, and it's verses 46 to 48.
A reading from the Gospel of Luke. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed." The word of the Lord.
And those words are, of course, from the Magnificat, the great prayer of Mary, in the Gospel of Luke. And now we'll hear them read out in German.
Lesung aus dem Lukas-Evangelium. Da sagte Maria, "Meine Seele preist die Größe des Herrn, und mein Geist jubelt über Gott, meinen Retter. Denn auf die Niedrigkeit seiner Magd hat er geschaut. Siehe, von nun an preisen mich selig alle Geschlechter." Wort des lebendigen Gottes.
We'll now hear those words of St. Luke, at this time in Spanish, which is, of course, the Pope's native language.
Lectura del Santo Evangelio según San Lucas. María dijo entonces, «Mi alma canta la grandeza del Señor, y mi espíritu se estremece de gozo en Dios mi Salvador, porque Él miró con bondad la pequeñez de su servidora. En adelante, todas las generaciones me llamarán feliz». Palabra del Señor.
And now that same reading, this time in Portuguese.
Leitura do Evangelho de São Lucas. Maria disse então, "A minha alma glorifica o Senhor e o meu espírito se alegra em Deus, meu Salvador, porque pôs os olhos na humildade da sua serva. De hoje em diante me chamarão bem-aventurada todas as gerações." Palavra da salvação.
And that same reading now in Arabic.
من إنجيل ربنا يسوع المسيح للقديس لوقا. فقالت مريم تعظم الرب نفسي وتبتهج روحي بالله مخلصي لأنه نظر إلى أمته الوضيعة. سوف تهنئني بعد اليوم جميع الأجيال. كلام الرب.
And now we'll have that final reading, this time in Polish. And after that we'll hear the Holy Father's catechesis for this week.
Czytanie z Ewangelii według świętego Łukasza. Wtedy rzekła Maryja: Wielbi dusza moja Pana i raduje się duch mój w Bogu, moim Zbawcy, bo wejrzał na uniżenie służebnicy swojej. Oto bowiem błogosławić mnie będą odtąd wszystkie pokolenia. Oto słowo Pańskie.
And Pope Francis' notes for this catechesis are now being brought to him, and we'll be hearing from him shortly.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning. We will conclude this cycle of catechesis by looking at a virtue which is not part of the seven cardinal and theological virtues, but which is at the basis of the Christian life. And this virtue is humility. It is the great antagonist of that most mortal of sins, namely arrogance. Whereas pride and arrogance swell the human heart, making us appear to be more than we are, humility restores everything to its correct dimension. We are wonderful creatures, but we are limited with qualities and flaws. From the very beginning, the Bible reminds us that we are dust, and to dust we shall return. Indeed, humble, the word humble, derives from humus, or earth. And yet, in the human heart, we often arise the delirium of omnipotence, which is so dangerous. And this does us a lot of damage. It takes very little to free ourselves from the demon of arrogance. It suffices to contemplate a starry sky, to restore the correct measure. As the psalm says, quote, "When I look at thy heavens, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars which thou hast established, what is man that thou art mindful of him? And the son of man that thou dost care for him." And modern science enables us to extend the horizon much, much farther and to feel the mystery that surrounds us and which we inhabit. Blessed are the people who hold in their heart the perception of their own smallness. And these people are preserved from a very ugly vice, arrogance. Arrogance. In his Beatitudes, Jesus starts precisely from them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven." It is the first beatitude, because it is at the base of those that follow. Indeed, meekness, mercy, and purity of heart stem from that inner sense of smallness. Humility is the gateway to all the virtues. In the first pages of the Gospels, humility and poverty of spirit seem to be the source of everything. The announcement of the angel does not happen at the doors of Jerusalem, but in a remote village in Galilee, so insignificant that people used to say, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" That's from John 1, verse 46. But it is exactly from there that the world is reborn. The chosen heroine is not a little queen who grew up coddled, but an unknown girl, Mary. She herself is the first to be astonished when the angel brings God's announcement. And in her hymn of prayer, the Magnificat, it is indeed this wonder that stands out. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. God is, so to speak, attracted by the smallness of Mary, which is, above all, an inner smallness. And he's also attracted by our smallness, when we accept our smallness. From here on, Mary is careful not to take the center stage. Her first decision, after the annunciation of the angel, is to go and help to serve her cousin.
Le persone umili dal proprio nascondimento non vogliono uscire mai. Gesù risponde sempre che sono beati gli umili.
Humble people don't want to put themselves in the spotlight, and Jesus says that the humble are blessed. Not even the most sacred truth of Mary's life, being the mother of God, becomes a reason for her to boast before men. In a world, we can imagine that Mary too had difficult moments, days when her faith advanced in darkness, but this never made her humility waver, because in Mary it was a granitic virtue, and I want to underline this. It's a granitic virtue.
La piccolezza che ci dà l'umiltà, e anche pensiamo a Maria, e la sua forza.
This smallness that comes from humility, and let's think of Mary.
Dio mi sia trionfante, va in frattumi. Fratelli e sorelle,
brothers and sisters, humility is everything. It is what saves us from the evil one and from the danger of becoming his accomplices. It is the source of peace in the world and in the church. Where there is no humility, there is war, there is discord, there is division. God has given us an example of this in Jesus and in Mary for our salvation and happiness. And humility is the way, it's the path to salvation. Thank you. So that was Pope Francis' catechesis for this week, and it will now be summarized in various languages. As I said at the beginning, I won't translate the summaries, but I will translate what comes after the summary, which is the Pope's exchange of greetings with the members of each language group. So now we have the first summary in French.
Il vous assure de leur prière à toutes les intentions de votre ministère apostolique universel. À la fin de l'audience, nous chanterons le Notre Père en latin, puis le Saint-Père donnera la bénédiction apostolique. Il accorde spécialement aux enfants, aux personnes âgées et aux personnes qui souffrent. Il bénira également les chapelets et les autres objets de dévotion que vous avez apportés à cette intention. Voici un résumé en français de la catéchèse que vient de prononcer le Saint-Père. Chers frères et sœurs, au terme de notre cycle de catéchèse sur les vices et les vertus, arrêtons-nous sur l'humilité. Si elle n'est pas dans la liste des vertus théologales ou cardinales, elle est pourtant à la base de la vie chrétienne. Face à l'orgueil qui nous gonfle et nous fait paraître plus que nous sommes, l'humilité nous ramène à notre juste dimension. La Bible nous dit que nous sommes poussière et que nous y retournerons. Parmi les béatitudes, Jésus place l'humilité en premier, car elle est la porte d'entrée de toutes les vertus. Dieu nous en a donné des exemples en Jésus et Marie. L'annonce de l'ange se fait dans un village perdu de Galilée à une jeune fille inconnue qui en est surprise, d'où son Magnificat. Dieu est attiré par sa petitesse intérieure. Dans un monde de paraître, elle demeure discrète. Son humilité et sa force invincible qui lui permet de demeurer au pied de la croix devant l'épreuve de l'humiliation du Christ. L'humilité est tout. Elle nous sauve du malin, elle est source de paix pour l'Église et le monde. Maintenant, le Saint-Père va saluer en italien les fidèles de langue française.
Saluto cordialmente i pellegrini di lingua francese, in particolare le parrocchie, le scuole e i gruppi di preghiera venuti dalla Francia e da Monaco. Tra loro il liceo dell'Immacolata Concezione di Laval. Contempliamo la Vergine Maria mettendoci alla sua scuola di umiltà e camminiamo con lei sui passi di Cristo e la via più sicura verso il cielo. Dio vi benedica.
Vous saluant en italien, le Saint-Père vient de dire: Je salue cordialement les pèlerins de langue
française. I cordially greet the French-speaking pilgrims, especially the parishes, schools, and prayer groups that have come from France and Monaco, especially the lycée of the Immaculate Conception of Laval. Let us contemplate the Virgin Mary by putting ourselves in her school of humility and walk with her in the steps of Christ. This is the surest way to heaven. God bless you.
Vers le ciel. Que Dieu vous bénisse.
And we'll now hear the summary and exchange of greetings in English. And you won't require translation for that one.
Most Holy Father, the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors wish to express to you their sentiments of deep respect and esteem, and to assure you of their prayers for your ministry as the successor of Peter. At the end of the audience, we will sing together the Our Father in Latin. His Holiness will then impart his apostolic blessing, which he extends in a particular way to the members of your families at home. He also intends to bless any religious articles you may have brought for this purpose, and in a special way, his blessing goes to your children, the elderly, and those who are sick. The following is a summary of the Holy Father's catechesis at the beginning of the audience. We now conclude our cycle of catecheses on the virtues by reflecting on the virtue of humility, by which we acknowledge that we are creatures of God and strive to live accordingly. Humility is, in fact, the door to the other virtues and, with poverty of spirit, the first of the Beatitudes. We see this in a particular way in the life of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Her humility is seen not only in joyful acceptance of the Lord's will, but also in charity toward her cousin Elizabeth, in perseverance beneath the cross, and in her prayerful presence among the apostles in the upper room, as they awaited the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. May her example and powerful intercession help us to overcome our temptations to pride, to follow humbly in the footsteps of Jesus, and to bear witness to the joy and peace of his kingdom. The Holy Father will now greet us in Italian.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua inglese presenti all'odierna udienza, specialmente ai gruppi provenienti di Sudafrica, Hong Kong, India, Corea, Filippini e Stati Uniti. Invoco su di voi la gioia e la pace di nostro Signore Gesù Cristo. Dio vi benedica.
I extend a warm welcome to the English-speaking pilgrims and visitors taking part in today's audience, especially the groups from South Africa, Hong Kong, India, South Korea, the Philippines, and the United States of America. I invoke upon you and your families the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. God bless you.
And we'll now hear the summary and exchange of greetings in German.
Heiliger Vater, die Gläubigen deutscher Sprache möchten Ihnen ihre herzliche Zuneigung und aufrichtige Verbundenheit bekunden und versichern Sie zugleich Ihres Gebets und in allen Anliegen Ihres universalen apostolischen Dienstes. Zum Schluss dieser Audienz singen wir gemeinsam das Vaterunser in lateinischer Sprache. Danach wird der Heilige Vater den apostolischen Segen erteilen. Gern schließt er darin ihre Angehörigen ein, besonders die Kinder, die älteren Menschen und die Leidenden. Er segnet auch die Rosenkränze und die übrigen Andachtsgegenstände, die sie dafür mitgebracht haben. Es folgt nun eine Zusammenfassung der Katechese des Heiligen Vaters in deutscher Sprache. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern, zum Abschluss unserer Katechesen über die Tugenden wollen wir heute über die Demut nachdenken, auch wenn diese nicht zu den Kardinaltugenden oder den göttlichen Tugenden gehört, bildet sie doch eine wesentliche Grundlage christlichen Lebens. Der Mensch, von Gott groß und wunderbar geschaffen, gerät nur allzu leicht in eine Haltung des Hochmuts und des Stolzes. Und so erinnert die Bibel gleich zu Beginn daran, dass der Mensch vom Erdboden genommen ist und zum Staub zurückkehren wird. Das demütige Bewusstsein der eigenen Schwachheit und Begrenztheit ist heilsam und begünstigt viele weitere gute Grundhaltungen wie Sanftmut, Barmherzigkeit und Reinheit des Herzens. Maria ist uns darin das bedeutendste Vorbild. Aufgrund der Demut seiner Magd konnte Gott Großes an ihr vollbringen. Der Heilige Vater richtet nun einen kurzen Gruß auf Italienisch an die deutschsprachigen Gläubigen.
Cari fratelli e sorelle di lingua tedesca, in questo mese dedicato alla Madre di Dio, impariamo da lei l'umiltà, perché l'Onnipotente possa compiere grandi cose anche in noi e attraverso di noi. Maria, umile serva del Signore, prega per noi.
Ich übersetze. Liebe Brüder und Schwestern deutscher Sprache.
Dear German-speaking brothers and sisters, in this month dedicated to the Mother of God, let us learn humility from her, so that the Almighty might also accomplish great things in us and through us. Mary, humble servant of the Lord, pray for us. And now that same summary will be read out in Spanish.
Santo Padre, los visitantes y peregrinos de lengua española que participan en esta audiencia desean manifestarle cordialmente sus sentimientos de filial afecto, que acompañan con fervientes oraciones por sus intenciones de pastor de toda la Iglesia. Al final de este encuentro se cantará el Padre Nuestro en latín. Después, su santidad impartirá a todos los presentes la bendición apostólica, que extiende complacido a sus familiares, especialmente a los niños y a los ancianos, a los enfermos y a cuantos sufren. Bendice también los rosarios y objetos de devoción que los peregrinos llevan consigo.
Pope Francis will read out himself the summary in Spanish, since it's his native language.
Queridos hermanos y hermanas, concluimos hoy el ciclo de catequesis dedicado a los vicios y las virtudes. Y hoy reflexionamos sobre la humildad, una virtud que está en la base de la vida cristiana y es la gran antagonista del peor de los vicios, que es la soberbia. La humildad nos ayuda a ubicar todo en su justa medida. Somos criaturas maravillosas, pero limitadas, con cualidades y defectos. Humildad es andar en la verdad, decía Santa Teresa. En las Bienaventuranzas, Jesús menciona algunas actitudes que nacen de la humildad. como la mansedumbre, la misericordia y la pureza del corazón. Esta disposición interior nos ayuda a combatir el orgullo y los delirios de grandeza que tantas veces surgen dentro de nosotros. Para ahondar en esta virtud, contemplemos a la Virgen María, modelo de humildad y pequeñez. En la vida oculta, libre de ambiciones y vacía de sí, María hizo de toda su vida un Magnificat. Saludo cordialmente a los peregrinos de lengua española. Pidamos a María que nos enseñe a vivir.
I coolly greet the Spanish-speaking pilgrims. Let us ask Mary to teach us to live the virtue of humility, proclaiming the greatness of the Lord and thanking Him because He looks upon our littleness with love and mercy. May Jesus bless you and the Holy Virgin watch over you. Thank you very much. And so now we'll hear that summary and exchange of greetings, this time in Portuguese.
Santo Padre, os fiéis de língua portuguesa desejam-lhe testemunhar afeto filial e fidelidade sincera e rezam por todas as intenções do seu ministério apostólico universal. Ao final da audiência, cantaremos a oração do Pai Nosso em latim. Depois, o Santo Padre vai conceder a bênção apostólica de modo especial às crianças, aos idosos e aos doentes, e vai abençoar também os rosários e demais objetos de devoção que cada um traz consigo. Leio agora um resumo da catequese que o Santo Padre acaba de pronunciar. No rol das virtudes cardeais e teologais não consta a humildade, no entanto, é a porta de acesso a todas as outras virtudes. Por isso, concluo este ciclo de catequeses refletindo sobre ela, que nos permite enfrentar o mais mortífero de todos os vícios, ou seja, a soberba. A humildade, ao mesmo tempo que nos recorda que somos criaturas maravilhosas, não deixa perder de vista a nossa pequenez, tal como aconteceu com Maria. Ela, sabendo que era mãe de Deus, não se envaideceu, mas se colocou ao serviço da prima Isabel, que estava para ser mãe. Maria conservou-se sempre pequena, despojada de si mesma e livre de ambições. E como seu filho, nos mostra que a humildade é a fonte de tudo. Agora o Santo Padre saúda em italiano os fiéis de língua portuguesa.
Do il benvenuto a tutti i pellegrini di lingua portoghese presenti all'odierna udienza. Come ha fatto nel giorno della Pentecoste, Maria continua oggi a raccogliere nella casa della Chiesa ciascuno dei suoi figli. Perseveriamo nella preghiera con la nostra madre. Dio vi benedica.
Eis a tradução de suas palavras.
I welcome all Portuguese-speaking pilgrims present at today's audience. As she did on the day of Pentecost, Mary continues today to gather each of her children into the house of the Church. Let us persevere in prayer with our Mother. God bless you. And we heard some cheers there from the Portuguese-speaking pilgrims. There were some people waving a Brazilian flag. And now we'll hear the summary and the exchange of greetings in Arabic.
أيها الأب الأقدس يسر المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية الحاضرين هنا أن يعبروا لكم عن مشاعر الاحترام والتقدير وشكرهم البنوي ويرفقونها بصلواتهم الدائمة إلى الله من أجل قداستكم وخدمتكم كخليفة القديس بطرس. في نهاية هذه المقابلة سنرتل معا صلاة الأبانا باللغة اللاتينية ثم سيمنح الأب الأقدس جميع الحاضرين البركة الرسولية ويشمل بها جميع أحبائكم وخاصة الأطفال والمتزوجين حديثاً والمسنين والمرضى والمتألمين بآلام شديدة وسيبارك كذلك المسابح والأشياء التقوية التي يحملها معه كل واحد منكم إليكم ملخص التعليم المسيحي لقداسة البابا فرانسيس اختتم قداسة البابا اليوم سلسلة التعليم في الرذائل والفضائل بكلامه على فضيلة التواضع قال فضيلة التواضع ليست جزءاً من الفضائل الرئيسية الأربع والفضائل الإلهية الثلاث ولكنها أساس الحياة المسيحية والمدخل إلى كل الفضائل التواضع هو المضاد الأكبر لأخطر الرذائل أي الكبرياء
لكي نحرر أنفسنا من شيطان الكبرياء يكفي أن نتأمل في السماء المرصعة بالنجوم لكي نعرف أننا صغار. في الصفحات الأولى من الأناجيل التواضع وفقر الروح يبدوان ينبوع كل شيء. نرى ذلك عندما اختار الله مريم المتواضعة وفي مدينة لا شأن لها لتكون والدة ابنه يسوع. لم تتفاخر بذلك أمام الناس، بل عاشت حياتها بتواضع وبقوة نعمة الله فقط. بالتأكيد عاشت هي أيضاً لحظات صعبة وأياماً كان إيمانها فيها يتقدم في الظلام، لكن هذا الأمر لم يزعزع تواضعها قط. كان صغرها هو قوتها التي لا تقهر، فهي التي بقيت عند أقدام الصليب، وفي الأيام التي سبقت عيد العنصرة هي التي جمعت التلاميذ الذين لم يستطيعوا أن يسهروا مع يسوع في آلامه. التواضع ينقذنا من الشرير، وهو ينبوع السلام في العالم وفي الكنيسة. أعطانا الله إياه مثالاً في يسوع ومريم من أجل خلاصنا وسعادتنا. والآن تحية البابا باللغة الإيطالية لأبناء الشرق الناطقين اللغة العربية.
Saluto i fedeli di lingua araba. L'umiltà ci libera dall'orgoglio e ci apre la grazia di Dio, permettendoci di vivere in comunione con Lui e in comunione con i nostri fratelli e sorelle. Il Signore vi benedica tutti e vi protegga sempre da ogni male.
أحيي المؤمنين الناطقين باللغة العربية. التواضع يحررنا من الكبرياء.
I greet the Arabic speaking faithful. Humility frees us from pride and opens us to God's grace, enabling us to live in communion with Him and with our brothers and sisters. May the Lord bless you all and protect you always from all evil. And now the final summary and exchange of greetings, this time in Polish, and after that the Pope will then greet the Italian speaking faithful, and that will be the last thing he says really before the praying of the Our Father and the Apostolic Blessing.
Waszej świątobliwości wyrazy synowskiego oddania i szczerej wierności, zapewniając o modlitwie we wszystkich intencjach jego apostolskiej posługi. Na zakończenie audiencji zaśpiewamy modlitwę Ojcze Nasz po łacinie. Po jej zakończeniu Ojciec Święty udzieli apostolskiego błogosławieństwa, obejmując nim szczególnie dzieci, osoby w podeszłym wieku i dotknięte cierpieniem. Pobłogosławi także różańce i dewocjonalia, jakie pielgrzymi przynoszą ze sobą. Oto streszczenie katechezy Ojca Świętego. Kończymy ten cykl, rozważając cnotę, która nie znajduje się w wykazie siedmiu cnót kardynalnych i teologalnych, lecz tkwi u podstaw życia chrześcijańskiego – pokorę. Jest ona wielkim przeciwnikiem najbardziej śmiercionośnej z wad, a mianowicie pychy. Błogosławieni, którzy zachowują w sercu świadomość swej małości, są chronieni przed arogancją. Pokora to brama wejściowa do wszystkich cnót. Widzimy to w Maryi, która posiadała zapewne wiele zalet, ale w Ewangelii została wymieniona tylko jej pokora. Na pewno i ona przeżywała chwile trudne, dni, kiedy jej wiara kroczyła w ciemności. Ale mimo to nigdy nie zachwiała się w pokorze, która w Maryi była cnotą jak ze skały. Ta jej małość jest jej niezwyciężoną siłą. Pokora ocala od złego i przed zagrożeniem stawania się jego wspólnikami. Jest źródłem pokoju na świecie i w Kościele. Bóg dał nam jej wzór w Jezusie i Maryi dla naszego zbawienia i dla naszego szczęścia. Teraz usłyszymy pozdrowienia Ojca Świętego skierowane do nas, Polaków, w języku włoskim.
Saluto cordialmente i Polaki. Maggio è tradizionalmente il mese delle prime comunioni nel vostro paese. Rivolgo un pensiero a tutti i bambini che vivono questo importante incontro con Gesù e li incoraggio in questo momento di gioia a saper vedere anche la necessità dei loro coetanei che soffrono vittime della guerra, della fame, della povertà. Maria ci insegna l'umile servizio che è fonte di pace nel mondo e nella Chiesa. Vi benedico di cuore.
Oto słowa Ojca Świętego. Witam serdecznie Polaków.
I coldly greet the Poles. May is traditionally the month of First Communions in your country. I address my thoughts to all the children who are experiencing this important encounter with Jesus, and I encourage them at this time of joy to see also the needs of their peers who suffer, victims of war, hunger and poverty. May Mary teach us humble service, which is the source of peace in the world and in the Church. And I bless you from my heart. And so now we have the final greetings in Italian. There'll be no summary, of course, because the Pope read out his catechesis originally in Italian. And it's normally the greetings to Italian speakers that contain if the Pope has a political appeal he wants to make. So we'll see if there's a political appeal forthcoming this week. What's being announced now in Italian is what was announced in every other language as well, explaining that the greetings to the Italians will be followed by the singing of the Our Father and with the apostolic blessing. So we now wait just a moment for these announcements to finish, and then Pope Francis will greet the Italian-speaking pilgrims.
Agli anziani e ai sofferenti. Benedirà anche i rosari e gli oggetti di devozione che ciascuno porta con sé.
Rivolgo un cordiale benvenuto ai pellegrini.
I extend a cordial welcome to the Italian-speaking pilgrims. In particular, I greet the novices taking part in the course promoted by the Union of Major Superiors of Italy, and I hope that this meeting will awaken in each one the desire to adhere ever more closely to Christ and to serve their neighbour in society, in charity. I can see these novices and I ask myself, how many are Italian? Not many. There's a scarcity of vocations in Italy, so let's think and let's pray for vocations to the consecrated life. I warmly welcome the Italian Federation of Local Authorities in Healthcare and the University Center for Nursing and Physiotherapy in Brindisi, and a cheer from those groups, encouraging them to always place the human person at the center, especially in delicate moments of life such as that of illness. And finally, my thoughts go out to the sick, the elderly, newlyweds and young people, especially the students from Frata Maggiore and Angri. May the Holy Spirit, whose presence in the Church we recalled on the recent solemnity of Pentecost, always dwell in your hearts, and may and help you to be strong in faith, generous in charity, and persevering in hope. And let us pray for peace. We need peace. The world is at war. Let us not forget martyred, tormented Ukraine, which is suffering very much. Let us not forget Palestine, Israel. Let us hope that that war ends. Let us not forget Myanmar. And let us not forget many, many countries at war. Dear brothers and sisters, we have to pray for peace in this time of world war. May the Lord bless you. May Mary watch over you. And please Do not forget to pray for me.
Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Domino vobiscum.
Et cum spiritum tuo.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui feci caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
So that was the Holy Father's apostolic blessing, and with that blessing, which went out to all of you listening live, we come to an end of this live broadcast of Pope Francis' general audience of today, Wednesday, May the 22nd. Today, Pope Francis brought his cycle of catechesis, which has been going on for a while, on the virtues and vices to an end, and with a reflection on the virtue of humility. He's now taking a moment to greet some of the bishops that were present at today's audience. And the Pope said that, quote, humility is the greatest antagonist of the most mortal of sins, namely arrogance. And he added that it is the gateway to all the other virtues, saying that meekness, mercy, and purity of heart stem from that inner sense of smallness. If you want to listen back to this event at any time, you can find it on our Vatican News YouTube channel and on our Vatican News website, where you can also find summaries of everything the Pope has been saying and doing recently. You can find us at www.vaticannews.va, and please do, while you're at it, also take a look at our Facebook, X, and Instagram pages. You can just search Vatican News on any of those social networks. I'm Joseph Tullock, thank you very much for tuning in, and please do join us again at the same time next week. Laudate Jesus Christus, praised be Jesus Christ.